My name is David Layden. I'm a third year student in Paola Capilaro's group, and I work on quantum engineering. I'm originally from Montreal. I did my undergrad at the University of Waterloo in Ontario, and I studied physics there. Over the course of doing a few of these terms in labs, I ended up working in this field and never really left. The research that I'm involved in mainly involves stabilizing quantum systems. So, for instance, certain types of defects in diamonds or special types of electronic circuits. These could potentially be very useful for us, but they also suffer from the problem of being very, very fragile. And so the smallest little bump or disturbance from their environment will cause them to lose their distinctly quantum nature. And so a big part of what I do is trying to find ways to extend their quantum lifetime, if you will. It involves trying to find ways to figure out what exactly is causing the quantumness in our systems to decay, and trying to keep that at bay without having other adverse effects on our systems. One of the exciting things we're pursuing is making sensors out of quantum systems. The difficulty, though, is that this is a double-edged sword, right? That they're sensitive to their to the signal that it is that you're trying to measure, but also to any disturbances that you are not able to control. And so one of the key challenges is to try and control these quantum systems in a way that you can essentially filter out these disturbances from the environment, but keep the stuff that you're interested in. So there's a number of different quantum technologies that people are excited about these days. One of the ones that you'll hear a lot about is quantum computing, where in principle, a computer that's based fundamentally on quantum physics could solve certain problems that are intractable today. On the nearer term scale, people are interested in things like sensors or communication networks that are based on quantum physics. So I think one of the really exciting parts is seeing how fields that seem completely different come together to create something new here. For instance, in the sensing applications that we work on, we borrow tools, let's say, that have been developed for quantum computing and tools from electrical engineering that are used for signal processing. We'll put these things together, and what you end up with is a result where you can recognize the original contributions that went into it, but it really gives you something that's brand new, something that is wholly different than the sum of its parts. I think what I do in the future will depend a lot on where this field goes. Even quite recently, let's say 5 years ago, this was this sort of research was mostly done academically, but now there's been quite a lot of industry interest as things from the academic sector mature. And so depending on how these different ways of moving forward in this field mature and progress, I'll see what opportunities arise.